We come now in our series looking at great chapters of the Bible to the Old Testament book of 1 Samuel. Chapter 17 in particular is the study that we're going to be considering for the next few weeks, and it involves David's battle against Goliath and the lessons we can learn from David's character as a way to apply that to our lives and see how we can improve as human beings, as servants of God, etc. There are three lessons we're going to look at for the next 3 weeks, and they all come from David's moral stand against injustice and his willing to fight on behalf of God. His unwillingness to give up that desire to fight, though obstacles are put in front of him over and over. The first lesson we'll learn comes from verse 26 through 30, and that is, as we go through our lives, we should, like David, we should be persistent in our willingness to stand for God. Be persistent. Notice verse 26 through 30, and David spoke to the man that stood by him, saying, "What shall be done to the man that kills this Philistine and takes away the reproach from Israel? For who is this uncircumcised Philistine that he should defy the armies of the living God?" The background, of course, is Goliath has already been taunting the Israelites, none of whom are brave enough to go and face him in battle. He's 9'9", he's a giant, he's got a big sword, big shield, big terrifying ugly face, I'm sure, and he screams insults to God's people and to God himself. And David looks around, this little kid looks around and says, "Who of us is going to go and fight this guy? I mean, listen to what he's saying about God. I mean, surely someone must have challenged him, but no one has." Verse 27, "And the people answered him after this manner, saying, 'So shall it be done to the man that kills him.' And Eliab, his eldest brother, heard when he spoke unto the men. And Eliab's anger was kindled against David. And he said, 'Why came thou down hither? And with whom hast thou left those sheep in the wilderness? I know thy pride and thy naughtiness of thine heart, for thou art come down that thou mightest see the battle.' And David said, 'What have I now done? Is there not a cause?' And he turned from him toward another and spoke after the same manner. And the people answered him again after the former manner." His brother says, "I know why you're here. You're just here to look at the battle." And David says, "No, I want to know who's going to fight this giant. My attitude is not about me," though he's accused of pride by his brother. David says, "My attitude is, who's going to defeat this bad guy? Who's going to defeat this guy who's mocking God?" And his brother just shoots him down. He says, "You need to get out of here and go back to watching the shepherds, or watching the sheep, because that's all you are. You're just a little shepherd boy." And then after that, everybody turns to themselves and says likewise to him, "Get on out of here, David. We don't want you here." And yet he's persistent. He doesn't give up. He's not deterred by negative Nancys. He looks around the camp of the Israelite army and he wonders aloud, who's going to challenge Goliath? They tell him that if someone did and won, then the Philistines would fall and serve the Israelites. That's what Goliath had said earlier. And so when David asked them, what is the great reward for defeating Goliath? They tell him, but no one goes to fight him. Because it's almost like a lost cause to these people, these faithless Hebrews. They are told, well, if we go and fight him, and if we beat him, then the Philistines will serve him. And they say it as though it's just an impossibility. And as he's doing this, his brother comes up and says, "Get lost, kid." And David thinks, someone's got to fight him. And his persistence, he doesn't run away. Though there's negative Nancys all around him, though Debbie Downers just litter the army of the Israelites, he doesn't get depressed with them. He doesn't fall into the peer pressure of depression and be overcome by the sorrow and the assumption of failure on the part of the Israelites. He's persistent. What can we learn from that? When we have a job to do, when there is a crusade to be fought, when there is something that needs to be stood up for, especially if it's a holy thing, we need to be persistent. There will always be people around us who thrive on negativity, and they love tearing other people down. It's because their own self-worth, amongst their own opinion of themselves, is so low, they want to pull everyone else below it. And so don't let those people pull you down. Don't fall into the trap of negativity. It's so easy to say it can't be done. David's attitude is, it not only can be, but it should have already been done yesterday. Who will step up? And unfortunately, right now, no one will. Second lesson we'll learn, we'll notice next week, and it is in the midst of his conversation with Saul, the King Saul. We'll see that this time next week. But the first lesson is powerful enough. Be persistent. Don't give up. Though everyone tries to pull you down, you stay faithful because you know what's right. You stay true to God. Be persistent, number one. We'll look at lesson number two this time next week. Until then, thank you very much.